One Hero Series live from Beijing, and we have got 8 contests for you today. Steve Dawson alongside Gianni Suba, and lots of great action for you coming up. We've got mixed martial arts, we've got Muay Thai contests, and we've got kickboxing contests. So plenty for you to get your teeth into today. Just giving you a summary of what's coming up so far. A great stage for young athletes to present themselves to the powers that be within the ONE Championship organization, offer themselves for the big stage. We'll take you through them bout by bout, and there's plenty of reason for you to enjoy the action. We're in Beijing, and we've got plenty of very, very promising Chinese fighters for you today. Here's our first contest, and it's Huang Ding against Yuan Hao. This is in the flyweight division, and this is a Muay Thai contest for you to enjoy. We'll just give you a quick run over the rules, seeing as we've got 3 types of contests for you to enjoy today. 3 3-minute rounds. This will be judged using the 10-point must system. 3 knockdowns in a round do equal a technical knockout, which means the bout will be over. No throws, no grappling. Indeed. And as these two get together, side by side, you'll see there the red corner on the left of your screen, Yuan Hao, and Huang Ding will be wearing the blue tape around his gloves. Gianni, great opportunity for young men. These are 19 and 21 years old. What a stage, what a chance for them to show what they're made of.
What a stage it is.
Judge time, ready? Ready, go!
Opening bell then for round one. The touch of gloves. Muay Thai with fingerless mixed martial arts gloves here, so these punches will sting, that's for sure. But it also means that there'll be a bit of a challenge in protecting yourselves. Those bigger gloves provide a nice defensive barrier, don't they? But these mixed martial arts gloves, it's going to be just that little bit more difficult to prevent the punches coming through. That's a nice left hook to the body from Huang Ding.
Very nice left hook. Huang Ding has been initiating the clinch early on in this contest. Seems to be that he wants to utilize that advantage that he seems that he has.
2 years older. Starting his Muay Thai career, but 3 years as a Muay Thai exponent now.
Huang Ding is favoring the left side, going to the left high, going to the left low, and attacking with the left elbow as well. That seems to be his power side.
Huang is one of only 2 athletes on show today who's no longer based in China. He's in Chiang Mai. So Muay Thai very much in his blood in the past few years, and that's what he's exhibiting tonight for us.
Yuan Hao steaming forward as well, straight line. Ready. Interesting tactic. Huang Ding has been closing off the distance, and Yuan Hao is closing that distance himself, giving Huang Ding that opportunity to work inside that clinch.
Yeah, they're not really keen to work at arm's length, are they? Particularly Huang, as you say, just gets straight back in there, leads with that left to the body quite often, then comes in close to the clinch. Good work inside there from Yuan.
Yuan Hao recognizing that this is going to be a close battle, starting to attack a little bit more inside the clinch, not allowing Huang Ding to dictate the strikes.
These two athletes, not the only ones working hard in there today. The referee's getting in there and separating these two men. They are so drawn to the clinch, as you've said, Gianni, that he has to get in there quite often and just part the two of them. There he goes again. As soon as he sees that they're not working.
Oh, the left upwards elbow drops Yuan Hao.
A little bit of a delayed reaction. He looks somewhat dazed, I must say, nodding at the referee to say, I'm all right. But the referee will have to convince himself of that. So Yuan goes down, and now Huang sees the opportunity, slings his man to the canvas.
Huang should utilize a little bit of Huang lands a right elbow for himself. These guys are going to battle.
That was a super elbow, a slashing throw.
Yuan Hao seems to be recovered.
He does, I agree with you. He seems to be all right now. It seems as if it's woken up, just ignited a spark in his day. Final 10 seconds of this opening round. Super left hook to the body again. That thudding leading left hook to the body. But that's a nice little combination indeed from Yuan.
Lots of volume by Yuan to end the round.
This one went back and forth in that opening 3 minutes.
Most of this contest was competed in the clinch. Both men landed some good strikes. Yuan hitting the upward elbow, drops Huang.
Let's take a look at some of the highlights, Gianni. Yeah. Take us through what we're seeing here.
He's been working on the left side the whole round. Gets him with the upward elbow or downward elbow. Look at that. Just arches forwards, catches him right
in the button. Real sharp end of the elbow as well. It was almost leading with the elbow, wasn't it? If you like kind of an elbow-style jab.
Yeah, Huang did a great job attacking on the left side. But Yuan came back himself with the right elbow that stopped the momentum of Huang. A knockdown means there's 10-8, automatically 10-8 on the scorecards.
Should be. I mean, that should be what the score is, 10-8. You could have one athlete really dominating the round, and then he gets knocked down in a flash knockdown. Wouldn't necessarily, therefore, be a 10-8 round, but all other things being equal, that's what we'd expect to see. And as we might expect to see, a little bit of swelling around the right eye there of Yuan. Let's see how this second round comes about.
Huang goes back to the left side, attacks again, but Yuan powers, charges forward. Good little sweep by Huang.
They come in swinging with these body punches. That's a
that. Leads with
hand.
The left hook.
Gonna switch between a cross between a jab and a hook, that one. There's no setting up punches here, is there?
Yuan seems to have the advantage with the boxing. That could be why Huang wants to close the distance, but Huang drops Yuan again.
Yeah, and Yuan actually threw a decent left hook at the same time, but he got caught at exactly the same time.
That
and
might
I
be
think,
it.
Gianni, he's not getting up from this.
Well,
he got up
count.
At the count of 9. Referee sends him back into the fray again.
Huang goes straight to work.
Again leading with the left hook to the body. So
knees to the body this time.
Remember, 3 counts in a single round represents a technical lockout. He looks as if he's had enough, Gianni, doesn't he?
Yeah, he might not continue. The referee waves it off.
Yeah, that's it. You could see from his facial expression that he probably had just about enough. And I think the way he's just sort of grasping at his ribcage there, that those lead left hooks to the body were what probably did the damage right at the end of that. Let's take a look at some of the damage that took place in that second round, and you can give us your thoughts, Gianni, but at the end there was some orthodox.
Yeah, very aggressive work by Huang, very active, worked on his left power side. It was the left to the body here that one did the damage. I think that one hurt him. Follows up with some clinches, knee strikes to the body, and you can see just Yuan is hurt there. Referee steps in.
Not often that
gives
you
him
see
the eight count.
An athlete leading with a left hook to the body, but this was something that Huang made a bit of a habit of, and successfully so. And when we talk about blows to the body, that knee, I think, was the final insult, wasn't it? That's what seemed to do the damage.
Smart work by Huang.
Winner!
So that's the win for Huang. We've got Meng Ketuogesi coming up in a catchweight competition, and we can learn a little bit more about him. He takes on Xia Ming Chuen next. That's coming up. Mixed martial arts for you.
中合格斗就是对符合我们这蒙古族的一种勇士的一个精神，对，就是体现自我的一个精神。我叫蒙克托格斯，我是一个蒙古族，我是在青岛新疆国际搏击俱乐部训练，因为我是个蒙古族，也就是从小的时候就是九，是有一些喜欢好斗的，特性就是从小就喜欢摔跤。09年的时候也是从事这个职业，就是刚开始练的拳击，然后慢慢就是练的摔跤，然后到现在的这个综合格斗。 就是综合格斗怎么说呢？就是给你带来是一种不一样的感受吧。最难的时候就是有时候也想，累的时候就想放弃这个职业。就说你每天就是反复的干一件事情，有时候会有一些反感吧，就那个时候就有那种感受。但是那时候你要有另一种想法，就是我就喜欢它，我要去实现它。变化就是成长了很多，然后认识了很多的人。 当从别人的对手或者是在别的事上学到了很多东西，让你感受到这个综合格斗是有魅力的。
Really good insight into just what hard work it is. This is mixed martial arts. Xia Mingchuan against Meng Ketuogesi. 25 years old, Meng. And we can take a look at some of the good work he's done in previous editions of One Hero Series, Gianni.
Let's take a look at some of Meng's highlights. Looks to have good drive on his double legs. Working the pass right away, very active from the top position. Meng seems to be a very explosive athlete. Very, very fast to look for the double leg, look for the takedowns. Beautiful single leg.
Yeah,
strong wrestling base he seems to have.
Yeah, very energetic, very fit, hungry. So that's the contest coming up for you. You guys watching on Facebook and YouTube, give us a little nod. It'll be great to know where you're watching from, who you are, see if we can give you a shout out from time to time. 25 years old. Meng Ketuogesi, 6-4 is his mixed martial arts record. Xia Mingchuan is 4-1-1, and at 18 years old, he is our youngest competitor today. So what a platform for him to take a big leap into the big time.
Meng coming out in the southpaw stance. Xia right away lands that straight right.
Yeah, we talked about how busy Meng looked in that highlight reel, but it's Xia that's taking the pace and dictating the pace early on.
Yep, Xia doing a great job of attacking the body with the front kick right away. Does not want Meng to get underneath, level change and take him down. So doing a good job of making Meng think right away. Look at that, front kicks down the center. Deterring Meng from level changing.
He's all action, isn't he? Moving on his toes all of the time. Backwards and forwards, left and right, hands are moving.
Meng gets in. Finishes a double leg. He's inside control already, looked at him, but you see Xia right away locks off the half guard.
Mixed martial arts inside what looks like a traditional boxing ring always creates some difficulties. And we had a takedown attempt there where the head was actually caught on the rope for a little while, just impeding the movement. We got there in the end.
Yeah, the rope actually favors the wrestler. It's a lot harder to stand back up because there's no cage, there's no ring. I mean, a panel to work yourself up.
To work your way up, yep. Yeah.
Look at Meng here, controlling the elbows, controlling the biceps of Xia, not allowing him to lock him up. Look for Meng to land some strikes here.
Xia with his legs wrapped around his body there. He's not letting that lock go.
Very active hips by Xia, not being in a stalemate. Meng popping up. I'd like to see him land some punches. But Meng knows that it's very early on in the round, wants to take his time.
There's one of those punches, came from way up high. But yeah, he's preoccupied with other things at the moment, isn't he? Can't really settle into any kind of ground and pound, effective ground and pound anyway.
Not yet, yeah. It's because of Xia's active hips. But Meng is very good base. Look at him, arches his hips high. Not allowing Xia to pull him down and threaten with any submissions. Good right hand by Meng.
Yeah, when he does throw those single right hands, they come, as I said, from a long way back. They look good and heavy.
Potential pass to the left, but no, Xia locks up the full guard again.
He's pulling that head in, isn't he? Meng trying to get him. I guess the idea is here to bring the body as close as possible, Gianni, so to limit the damage.
Xia wants to break the posture of Meng and not allow him to land hard and heavy shots. But Meng right away takes the back of Xia. Let's see if he's able to hold the position. He has one hook in, now has both hooks in. This is a dangerous spot for Xia. This is not where he wants to be.
Xia's got the left hand under control.
Yep.
Battling with that right hand. You can perform a rear naked choke just with the one arm, but it takes some strength and technique.
Yeah, great job by Meng to control the wrist of Xia. Oh, so they scramble up. Meng keeps top position, lands a good right elbow.
Yeah, the flat base of that elbow, the forearm really, just landing down. Another one with the left hand there.
You can just see the good base of wrestling by Meng. Very active, wants to stay on top position. Always moving, never conceding. Look at that, always scrambling.
It's perpetual movement, isn't it, from Meng? And that will certainly be noticeable in the eyes of the judges.
Ooh. Gives it up. Meng had his arm under the chin there, potentially rear naked choke, but look at Xia controlling the arms of Meng now.
as if he may try for it again. In the meantime, Xia just sends those punches over his head, trying to make a blind connection.
Yep, again, Meng gets that underhook, cranks him down, back into side control.
Forearm will press down on the face there, gives him his back.
Look at that, just beautiful grappling by Meng. Takes the back again of Xia, but Xia not conceding, constantly scrambling, moving his hips, staying active. That makes it very hard for you to hold someone down when they're constantly moving.
Yeah, Xia is relentless. He just won't concede any kind of position, will he? He's just moving from one position to another, keeping Meng on his toes, not literally, but certainly mentally on his toes.
This is a furious pace in the first round. But Meng again in the side control position.
Still 50 seconds left.
The Yuan belly moves straight to mount. Another bad spot for Xia, but Xia again. Hip bump, scrambles. What Xia needs to do is try to find a half guard.
Three good punches that came down there. And Xia just turns away from that, but that means he offers his back once again. Swings back around to face his opponent. And gives him his back again. He's just constantly squirming about, isn't he?
This is an exhausting round.
Like a fish in a net. Just wriggling. Won't give a consistent position for his opponent to work upon. 10 seconds left, not really enough time to work that rear naked choke to a conclusion.
But great way for Meng to end the round on the back of Xia.
Just in case they didn't hear that bell, the referee gave them a very loud equivalent to stop.
The whole round was controlled by Meng. Great job of him utilizing his advantage on the ground. Xia doing a great job of scrambling, never conceding position, battling out of bad positions, but Meng, look at him. Controlling the wrist, landing some hard ground and pound from top position, just good base here. Not allowing Xia to pull him down. Right elbow. The real story of this round was Meng transitioning from position to position. Conceding that sometimes like Xia would get up, but Meng just kept following him. Kept following him.
Xia gave him a moving target all the time, which is what made that opening round so intriguing.
That was a very exhausting pressure.
Are enjoying it at home. Henry Son from the United States. We've got Carla Wang Po from Bhutan. Lino from Mauritius. We've got people watching from New Orleans, Pakistan, Shoaib Khan Kaka from Pakistan. Good to have you all looking in. Love your company. Keep saying hi.
Let's see if Xia makes some adjustments this round. If I was Xia, I'd utilize a little bit more movement, not stay in the pocket, not have any exchanges, try to land with long-range shots.
That was a very positive step in from Meng there. Leading with that right hand, as you said very early on, Jiale stepped in and gave a very positive approach to his striking.
Good right hand there by Xia. Xia's taking a couple deep breaths.
Yeah, I was just about to say, boxing open mouth, and wow, he got caught there.
Lead uppercut by Meng.
Real couple of dingers, a left hand and a right uppercut. Super combination it was. Must say, Xia took it well. Oh, again, he gets hit flush. This is good work from Meng's hands.
Great job by Meng. Knows that he has a grappling advantage. Wants to strike with Xia a little bit. Get him think about the hands before hitting the level change. Or maybe Meng thinks that he has an advantage on the striking as well.
Entirely different identity to the first round. And this is some very, very nice work from Meng.
You can see the determination in Xia's face. This is a big contest for him. He does not want to lose this one.
Big left hand there. He hit in from that southpaw stance. Landed flush on the jaw. And really, Xia needs to lift his hands a little bit more because he's getting caught flush a little bit too often in this second round.
The pressure of Meng seems to be getting to Xia. Xia's in side control again. Has the left arm of Xia. Meng is in side control. Has the left arm of Xia pinned. Attacking the body, great job. Knows that Xia is tired. Attacking the body right now, just gonna fatigue Xia even more.
Yeah, deep penetrative punches to the side of the body there from that position. They'll hurt, take the wind out of you. Meng. All the while he's pressing down on the prostrate body of Meng. Yeah. Of Xia, I should say.
Yeah, Meng is very active. Slides right to mound. Bad, bad position for an exhausted Xia. Oh, hard elbow by Meng.
Yeah, looks as if he may be flagging a bit now. taken a few too many big blows to the head and face.
Xia still moving, but he's not intelligent defending himself anymore.
Yes, you're right. There's no intelligence defense there at all. And I think the referee is moments away from stepping in if Meng can continue this barrage. The only thing he's got to be careful of is not hitting Xia on the back of the head. That's a blow between the ears on the back of the head that doesn't touch an ear. But at the moment, they're face to face. There must be something like 40 unanswered blows or more coming in now. And surely the referee won't wait too much longer. And indeed, at the 2:15 mark of the second round, this one is over. And it was really an entirely different second round from the one we saw in the first stanza.
No questioning the heart of Xia, but it was all Meng this contest. Meng kept a furious pace that Xia just could not keep up with. Came out in the second round, started landing some hard shots with his hands. Couple lead uppercuts and straights. And then Xia just let Meng close the distance. Meng takes him down with the upper body lock, a front headlock, but look at the damage here. Look at the action here. Well, Meng strikes from ground and pound.
He always appreciates being part of a team, but this is a sport where certainly teamwork is a big part to play with your corner, but he's doing that all on his own in the ring. And it was, in the end, quite an exhibition of striking. Improves his record to 7-4, while Xia drops his record to 4-2-1. So the 25-year-old beats the youngest competitor that we have on show today. The referee ending that one after a volume of perhaps 50 or more unanswered punches will rain down. And Meng gets the win. This is One Hero Series. We're in Beijing, showcasing the youth of China's combat sportsmen. Super Series Muay Thai coming your way in the bantamweight division. Hu Binqian against Jiang Shuai. Great to see you guys tuning in. Jesha from Australia. Analia from Macau. Alia from Indonesia. George from Texas. We've got viewers in Zambia. These are the rules that we'll be following in this Muay Thai contest. 3 3-minute rounds, that 10-point must system used for the judging. Don't forget that 3-knockdown rule is in effect. If that happens once in a single round, then the referee will call a technical knockout. Muay Thai, sport you enjoy, Johnny?
I enjoy it very much. So beautiful, so technical, Muay Thai when it's done perfectly.
Yeah, the struggle for perfection is very common in this sport. It's a grueling session. But there's a lot at stake. If these young men can impress, then the prospect of a big contract on the big stage with one championship is always there. It's up to them. This is their moment. With the blue tape around his gloves, that's Jiang, and Hu there with the red tape and the white shorts. Both these men with a nice high guard, very typical of a Muay Thai stance, both leading with their left hand, but they'll stand fairly square on compared to, let's say, an international style boxer.
Hu just filling out the bout right now, landing some kicks, low kicks and push kicks. Jiang seems to want to engage with the hands.
Hu was sent to a martial arts gym to train when he was only 8 years old. His father sent him there. Went to a top martial arts school in China by the time he was 14. Trained in Sanda. Fifth place in the National Muay Thai Championships at the 57 kilo category. So really, this is something he's known all his life.
Chang Shuai leaps in with the left uppercut, right, right straight. They engage in the clinch. About a good knees by Hu.
Yeah, in that clinch there, the referee will get between them. Zhang, the provincial Sanda tournament that he participated in the first time. And then he won third place, second tournament. He won a gold. Then he became a... Then he changed up to Muay Thai and kickboxing, won the runners-up in the National Muay Thai Championship back in 2016, won the National Kickboxing Championship at both the ages of 17 and 18. So really, these two have dedicated their lives to the sport, to combat sports generally.
Both men seem to be faking, still trying to get a feel of what their opponent is good at. But Zhang seems to be wants to work towards the clinch.
What's different for these two guys, Jian, is that although they're very well versed in the sport of Muay Thai, they're now conducting themselves using these fingerless gloves. And it's an entirely different proposition, isn't it?
It's very different. The range when you're wearing mixed martial arts gloves, because of smaller padding, the range is very different. The punches have more effect, so you can't just cover up the way you would with bigger gloves. And with the little gloves, it favors clinching, so I can see why they are both engaging in the clinch more than usual.
Loving the way Hu just smiled at his opponent there as they broke away. Obviously enjoying this. This is when you have to recognize where you are. You've got to be there in the moment and realize the opportunity that's waiting for you.
Very closely contested first round. Both men not wanting to have the other men land the last strike.
Yeah, nobody wants to allow their opponent to leave the lasting impression upon the judges. The moment there, just looking at each other, the concentration level at a peak. Very, very nice sportsmanship there as they close that first round and go back to their corner. What's going through their minds, Gianni? Because they know, don't they, that this is their moment, potentially the crossroads in their combat sports career.
Yeah, this is a big, big moment for them. Both men had their moments in their first round. Hu landed some good kicks. Zhang with some good strikes to the body and then knees in the clinch as well. Very, very close round.
The thing about Muay Thai is that you get the competitive experience very early and at quite a pace. Zhang, for example, is 21. He's had 24 bouts, 19-5 record, very impressive. Hu is even younger at just 20 years old. He's had 26 contests, 19-6-1. So plenty of competitive experience for these two, but this will be the biggest contest of either man's career. Second round, three-minute rounds, remember. Both eager, both having to be sent back to their corner by the referee. The touch of gloves, and straight back into it. Clash of shins looks scary, doesn't it? But they're well used to that kind of contact. Seems to be Hu that leads off first, and he's therefore dictating the pace. For Chang, it's more of a reactionary.
Yep, both men are throwing kicks, but Zhang seems to want to use the kicks to set up his hands. Look at that. Oh, Zhang is looking for the elbows inside the clinch. He's looking to engage in the clinch and land elbows off of it.
Nice left hand from Hu there. Clean, straight punch landed on the jaw. Good work from the knees inside that clinch. The referee just doesn't like the idea that they spun around, so he's going to separate them and unto the breach once more. And there's that slapping sound again as both of them bring kicks up at the same time.
Yeah, Hu just switched over the southpaw stance, but Zhang Shuai comes in, lands a right hook over the top. Hu switching up the stances, maybe try to confuse Zhang a little bit. Both of them haven't found much success. Hu's just trying to switch it up, see if there's any openings.
Short right hand once they got into that clinch, and they're very, very keen, both of them, to exchange knees to the side of the body. Look how much Hu is enjoying this.
Both men are having fun out there.
Hu perhaps the slightly lighter on his feet. Perhaps the more energetic, as we said earlier, the more inclined to dictate the pace. Takes a couple of nice right hands there from Zhang, though.
Zhang
and again, he smiles it off.
Zhang is starting to find his range this round. Use the kicks to set up his right hand, land at a right elbow up after the right hand. So Zhang, even though Hu is moving a little bit more, Zhang is able to land the strikes.
Hu is absolutely intent on not letting Zhang have the last word, though. As soon as a decent strike comes in, he'll leap straight back into distance and land what he can. He wants the last word in every one of these little arguments. Spinning back kick.
Beautiful spinning back kick. Zhang is starting to work attack to the body now, mix it up. He knows that Hu is moving away when he throws strikes to the head, so he's going to mix it up.
A little bit attack to the body. Spinning back fist. To be fair, Hu didn't really have to duck much.
Look at that. Zhang just sliding away. Starting to find his range this round.
Inside the last half minute of this second round.
A little clash of heads there, but Zhang shakes it off. Go!
Final few seconds then of the second.
Beautiful right elbow to the left hook.
That's nice. A good work there at the end by Zhang, just trying to capture the judge's focus and attention in the final few moments of that round. It's energetic stuff, it's entertaining, and it's quite even, Gianni.
Very even. But this round definitely went to Zhang. Zhang was able to utilize his striking a little bit more, utilize his boxing and his elbows inside the clinch. Both men landed good right knees, a good right kicks, excuse me. Checks the kick, throws the right hand, look at this, follows up with the beautiful right elbow over the guard of Hu.
Little view on the corner work there, that Vaseline over the eyes, just to make sure that when the gloves strike the eyebrows that it's a glancing blow. The more friction there is when glove makes contact with skin, the more chance there is of opening up a cut. That can, of course, lead to fight-changing consequences.
Crucial third round here, Steve. Both men very closely contested fight. I would say the second round would give to Zhang. First round could have gone either way.
Yeah, completely agree with you. This could be the round that decides everything.
Great show of sportsmanship by both men.
Great having the sound, isn't it, of the foot on thigh. You really get a feel for how hard these blows are landing. There it is again.
Senses the urgency. Must have known that he lost the second round.
If we weren't really short on urgency in the second round, but as you say, it's all important now, isn't it, this third round. It's all got to be done now. You can't leave anything in the ring. Now, we're seeing Hu there just call for a short informal timeout while he tucks the bandage inside his fingerless glove. Didn't need any assistance from the referee. It was just a small thing. Seems to be sorted out.
Zhang Shuai started this round ending his punches with the kicks. But then Hu put the pressure on him, started to throw strikes of his own.
Was looking for that swinging elbow, Zhang, wasn't he? Just missed with it. Damaging blow. He looks for it again there. Of course, it's a shorter punch, so it's easier to miss with that.
The right elbow of Zhang has been the most significant strike of this contest.
I think we're seeing Hu there complain that there might have been a punch to the back of the head. No warning from the referee, but the two athletes know what's going on, and they give a quick embrace just to show that all's well. Look to tee off with that right hand, Zhang. Short that time, though. Both of them working relentlessly with the knees inside the clinch. There's not a moment's rest between these two from start to finish. We've got just under 90 seconds left now, and it's going to be close for these judges.
Zhang is looking to score over land shots over the top of the guard of Zhang Shuai. I mean, of Hu, I'm sorry. If you notice, Zhang is trying to loop the right overhand and the right elbow.
Oh, that's a good left hand,
beautiful
Gianni.
Beautiful left hook by Hu.
It removed the mouthpiece, and that's the kind of blow that could make the difference when the judges tabulate the various scores that they've been noting down. Good forearm blow.
60 seconds left in this round. Both men really going for it.
Yeah, Hu is not giving this one away. That was a very decent forearm indeed. Zhang may well have convinced the judges just because he gets to the strike first. And he's reluctant to not have the last word either. But it's been very close for these two.
That's what Zhang needs to go back to. Punch and kick. Mix it up.
Yeah, who a little bit too often is trying to do the referee's work for him. Should maybe just focus on avoiding that lead elbow that Zhang is throwing in. Final moments then, and the judges will indeed have to get their pencils and papers out and tabulate what they've seen. The 10-point must system in effect. Don't think we've seen any 10-8 rounds, that's for sure. But that was a very enthralling 9-minute contest. We'll take a look at that super blow that removed the mouthpiece, Gianni. And as we do that, who are you leaning towards?
Let's look at this. It was the left hook that knocks the mouthpiece out of Zhang.
Super blow, wasn't it?
Very, very closely contested bout. Both men had their moments. I'd give the second round to Zhang clearly. In the third round, I would give it to who? It all depends on what the judges saw, but I wouldn't be surprised if it went either way. But if I had to pick, I would give it to who?
I'd give it to who as well. Let's see what the judges say.
Winner!
We got it wrong, which just goes to show you can't be a judge when you're commentating. We spoke about this earlier on, Gianni and I.
Yep. Yeah.
When you're judging a contest, you need to look very, very closely, and I'm sure they made the right decision.
This is our journey. This is our mission. All of the places. All of the people. All of the smiles. The prayers. The late nights. The preparation. All of the sweat and tears. It's the match of our lives. It's our dedication to greatness. This is our world. This is our stage.
And there it is! Olympic! Come on! Good night! High three! Oh, Tony Duncan dropped it! How about this? It's so great!
Next up, we've got a catchweight contest for you. This is mixed martial arts in the red corner. Xiatihe Zhumatai, and he takes on Fan Jiale. Let's take a look at the mixed martial arts rules then. 3 5-minute rounds. Now, these bouts will be judged in their entirety, so we don't break these up round by round. No kicks to the head of a grounded opponent, no spiking, suplexes on the head, neck, or spine. You should all be familiar, you won championship fans, with our mixed martial arts global rule set.
Okay. Yeah.
Multicolored shorts.
Dud.
Of Xia.
Dud. Dud. Time to keep her. Ready? Fight!
And with the blue tape around his wrists, that is Fan.
Fan closing the distance right away, cutting off. But Xiat did a great job of circling away, keeping his range.
Good left hand from him. Went to a military school to practice Sanda at the age of 14 years old.
Fan has the double body lock here. Takes him down.
Now, Xia is a wrestler. He's been training in freestyle wrestling since he was a young child. Took 5th place in a national youth wrestling tournament. And he left school and switched to mixed martial arts, quickly won three bouts there and became a Mongolia Invitation Tournament champion. So thorough experience since he was very young. 21 years old now, as is his opponent.
Yeah, very active. Looking to lock up a potential submission here. You got both the arms trapped, controlling the arms of Fan.
Yeah, spins round, curls up into a ball, has a 2-3 mixed martial arts record.
Great job by Fan controlling him right now. He's got the wrist of Xiat trapped, but ooh. Thought he had a potential Kimura, but yeah, Xiat doing a great job controlling the wrist of Fan, getting himself up, reversing the position. Now has Fan on the ropes.
Fan is 3-1 as a mixed martial artist, looking for sweeps, the two of them.
Yep. Xiatihe hit a beautiful outside trip, ends up on top with knee on belly position. Oh, but good little hip bump there by Fan to reverse the position.
Yeah, nice athleticism. Knees to the midriff.
Xiatihe looking for the outside trip again and gets it. Beautiful outside trip by Xiatihe.
So
goes right back to the knee on belly position. Yeah.
Yeah, knee on belly. That makes things tough, doesn't it? Yeah. Tough to breathe apart from anything else.
What Xiao wants to do is prevent the explosion and movement of Fan. So keeping his back flat to the mat would be the best thing to do. He's transitioning to the armbar. Might have it, but no, Fan does a great job of moving away from the pressure. Both men back up to the feet again and in the clinch.
At times it looks perhaps a little bit untidy, but it's because both men are moving so quickly, preventing the opponent from really establishing their position.
Fan with the outside trip of his own. Both men exchanging takedowns this round. You can see that Fan has a knee in the middle, cuts across the side control position here, has the underhook on the left side of Fan. Oh, but Fan uses that underhook to pop back up. This is a very, very exciting grappling contest.
2 minutes left in the opening round.
Fan has the front headlock position there. A great job for Xiatihe to move away.
Yeah, a little bit of a respite for Xia. Moves away and then, having got his space and a moment to breathe, unloads with a few good punches and a couple of flying knees there.
Of beautiful knees.
Oh, suddenly, Fan is under the cosh, and he really ate a big knee there.
Xiatihe with a big jumping knee. Fan catches the leg though and drags him down with a beautiful single leg.
That's the problem, isn't it? You go for the single or the double leg, and you get a knee to the face.
The grappling exchanges have been really, really even. Both men working really hard. Look at that. Fan got taken down, worked back up, but wow, belly to belly toss there by Xiatihe.
Both of these men showing good strength. Oh, heavy elbow to the jaw. And that's a big blow for Fan.
Fan seems to be okay. But Xiatihe working to the back again, but Fan using that underhook to grab a single leg, works back up, reverses the position. Lots of grappling exchanges in this round.
Remarkable that he seems to have recovered from that blow enough to show the presence of mind to work intelligently on the floor. They're both back on their feet now, but
high
still
level
coming
grappling
to grips with each other. High level, you're right.
Showcased by both men. Now, Xiatihe with both men in the over-under position. We call this 50-50 position. Oh no, Xiatihe looked for an outside trip, but gets his back taken. No, Fan has a rear naked choke locked in.
Let's take a look and see how this
tight
goes.
That's it, wow.
He's gone. He tapped out on the blind side of the referee, but the ref was not slow to call it off.
One mistake by Xiatihe costs him the match. Fan locks up the rear naked choke to take the victory.
It was always going to be that way, Gianni, wasn't it? They were so evenly matched, they were moving so quickly. It was just a question of who would get that final position.
Lots of back and forth grappling in this round. Both men having the upper hand, then reversing and back and forth the whole round. But one mistake by Xiatihe. Look at this. In the over-under position, look to trip the outside leg, but Fan uses that momentum to end up on top and locks in that rear naked choke right away.
Yeah, there was no defense there at all, was there, at that time? The arms were apart and the throat was there for the taking.
No choice for Xiatihe to tap. Look at it again. Look at how he slides it in right away. Good hip pressure, squeezes hard. Xiatihe has no choice but to tap. Just one mistake. Lots of grappling exchanges, high level grappling by both men, but that's what happens. One mistake is all it takes at this level.
And Fan is making a nice comfortable little space for himself now. Improves his record to 4-1. Xia's record drops to 2-4. So it's that man in the black and red shorts, the blue tape around his gloves that really make him the standout performer in that contest. Now we've got a big event happening in Tokyo. Let's take a look.
I can't hear myself thinking. This is crazy. Tokyo. Here we go. The ticket time box exploded. The boom shakalaka. Oh my goodness. It's over. It's over. It's the Dunaway.
Yeah, big 100 event in Tokyo. We've got Manila coming up next with two world title contests, but we've got four contests coming up for you now here. One Hero Series from Beijing. We've got some mixed martial arts coming your way and a couple of Super Series kickboxing bouts as well. This is the stage where these young men can join a roster that includes 140 world champions from various martial arts. This one sees Tsuru take on Li Hong Lin, and let's take a look at some of the good work that Li Hong Lin has been a part of up to now. This one, a strawweight contest coming your way. Destructive stuff from Li Hong Lin taking on Zuru today. These guys looking to take their place among the elite in the world by winning a contract with one championship. The global rule set in play, 3 5-minute rounds, bouts judged in their entirety. We reach over 140 countries around the world with one championship these days. So let me take this opportunity to say hi to Sarif watching from Singapore, Carlo in California. We've got people watching in Uruguay and Belgium. Great to have you all with us.
Judge, time, ready, ready, go!
So, mixed martial arts. Li in the all red, Zuru with the blue tape around his gloves and the army fatigue trunks there.
See a significant reach advantage by Li.
Yeah, it looks that way, doesn't it, in that southpaw stance. Quite a bit taller than his opponent as well. It's 6 centimeters.
Zuru must have seen some tape of Li. You can tell he's really trying to move a lot with his feet, not get pushed by the pressure of Li.
Unavoidable at the moment, though.
Zuru has the back of Li, but Li's going to do a great job of breaking the grips of Zuru. Zuru takes him back to the, takes him to the ground, but Li, look at him, has wrist control. That's what he needs to do here. He needs to fight the wrist. Is that just exactly that?
That swinging right hand. Fortunate for Li that he was able to duck under it in plenty of good time, because that came with some ferocity.
Li just has a furious forward pressure. Straight line attacks.
He'll back off a little bit if he keeps getting kicks to the midriff like that, though. Overhand right there from Zuru.
That's exactly what Zuru needs to do. Zuru needs to gain the respect of Li by throwing hard strikes. make Lee hesitant to come in. But Lee charges forward again.
Zuru wrestling since the age of 14. Couple of years later, transition to Sanda.
Forward pressure by Lee. Yeah.
Just forward momentum all the time, Gianni. Just won't stop coming forward all the time.
That's what Zhu needs to do. Zhu needs to time. Zhu needs to time the forward pressure of Lee. Look to get underneath, and now he does. He has to back up Lee again, but Lee, very, very well trained. Attacks the hand right away, breaks free.
Zhu doing exactly what you were suggesting he should there, using his opponent's momentum to his advantage, just spinning him around, getting his back for a moment there. But really, Lee is all energy, and he wriggled out of that pretty quickly.
You can see that even when Zhu's not getting a takedown, he's attacking with strikes on the break.
At this pace, we're still only halfway through the first round. It might just be an issue of who's got the better cardio, Gianni.
Zer's doing a great job. He's slowing the momentum of Lee by closing the distance, attacking with strikes to the body. This will slow him down in the later rounds.
It does look to me as if Zuru is open mouthed, as is Lee. You can see that there. But it doesn't slow them down in any way, does it?
Not yet. There you go, another beautiful body kick by Zer.
Yeah, made contact with the body, but it also just caught the sharp point of the elbow, which can be a bruising for the man throwing the kick.
Great, beautiful work by Zer.
Driving takedown from Zeru.
Notice how Zer did two different things there. He closed the distance, landed a knee strike, and then level changed right away. Very, very tricky stuff by Zer. But again, Lee doing a great job of defending, but now gets the takedown of his own. Zer's supposed to have the wrestling advantage, but on the ground, wrestlers don't like to be on their back. Let's see how his Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is.
Using the flat side of his forearm, Lee there to send in 4 or 5 heavy blows now to the face.
There was a potential armbar by Zer, but not Lee. Pushed past the knees, now ends up in side control.
Again, not just blows, but using the forearm to press the face down. Just make it very uncomfortable for him and control the body. If you control the head, you control the body.
Yeah, bad spot for Zhu. Li Hong has it back, has the body triangle locked up there.
Just punching his way to get into position for a rear naked choke.
Zhu needs to stay calm, look to fight the wrists. He wants to go towards the side of where the figure four is. Right now, there's a lot of pressure on the body of Zhu.
You're saying Zhu needs to move to his right, roll around to his right?
To the right side and pin the ankle over there. Create some tension. Oh, but no, he has a really good choke locked in, but no.
That looks tight, though. He's got his hands around that to try and pull it away.
Well defended, he's got both hands on the wrist there, on the choking hand. Should be okay here.
Now working on the arm that's actually around the throat. Nicely done. Well defended, as you say, and he needed to defend well there. Not quite enough time to work with that rear naked choke attempt, but it was the first knock on the door, wasn't it?
Yep. Lee with a lot of forward pressure this round. Zhu, towards the end of the round, was able to close the distance, stop the forward pressure, landed some knees in the clinch, as well as body kicks to try and slow down Lee. But Lee, at the end of the round, gets a takedown of his own and lands some good ground and pound, takes the back of Zhu as well. Here it is with him with the body triangle, almost secured a rear naked choke. Near finish there by Zhu, by Lee.
Pretty relentless, these two, when they're on the deck in terms of punching as well as attempting submissions. Yeah, great work there, very entertaining. The referee had to be quick to make sure that the action stopped at the sound of the bell. Good day to you in Kenya. Raja's watching. We've got viewers in Nigeria. Roland's in Texas. Matthew elsewhere in the United States. Great to have you with us. This is a mixed martial arts contest. Second round, Li Honglin against Zuru.
Lee goes back to the strategy. Forward pressure again. Just always in the face of Zuru. Never giving him space to breathe.
Strawweight contest. Oh, right hand that was kind of telegraphed. He leant into it. Oh, big left hand from Lee, and it landed flush, and Zeru took that very well indeed.
Oh, Zeru might have a guillotine locked up there.
If you commit so heavily with a big punch like that, then your body will have to follow the punch, and the things like the guillotine then can naturally follow if you can remain alert enough.
Lee locked up, clasped his hands there, and took Zer down. Zer seems not to be as well versed on his back. Very, very active is Lee on top.
Prefers the flat of his forearm than the sharp point of the elbow, which can be a very damaging blow indeed.
Zer tried to sweep Lee, but ends up in mount. Has his back taken again. Figure four locked up for Lee again.
Oh, now there's that space to get that arm underneath.
It looks like he has the arm trapped underneath, but again, look. Zer has both arms on the choking hand.
It really looks tight and right underneath that chin, Gianni. It's going
to
be difficult.
This is just surviving right now. Zer needs to keep his chin down.
All right, so there was a brief break in the action there where they changed arms, and he used that time to get that chin down, as you suggested.
Yep, Lee's really working for the finish. Look at him. Trying to occupy Zer, trying to make Zer think about the punches, then trying to snake one of his arms in for the rear naked choke. But, oh, might have an armbar here. Dives for it, but no, Zer is okay. Zer pulls out, ends up on top.
Using his feet to keep his opponent away there.
Zer has the back of Lee now. Let's see if he's able to keep the position. See how he does when, oh, he has the back of Lee.
Thought about the underhook under the armpit there, but goes over the shoulder instead, looking for that throat.
Lee has exerted a lot of energy in the beginning of this round. Let's see if Zer is able to capitalize. Oh, he has the arm underneath. He might have it here.
He's tapped.
Wow. What a finish by Zer.
And look how exhausted the two of them are there.
Zer looked to be close to being finished the whole round, comes out, takes the back of Lee, and secures the finish.
Come from behind in many ways. Great effort. Look at the range of emotions, the disappointment there.
I think the pace of Lee was just not sustainable. Here he got his back taken, and Zer works for the rear naked choke here, battles. You see Lee still defending right now, has his hands on the wrist, but Zer doing a great job pushing the wrist of Lee away. Locks up the rear naked choke,
and
that is tied.
In incremental movements, eventually got there, and you could see how upset Lee Hong Lin was.
Winner!
So, Zeru improves his record, and it's an impressive one, isn't it? To 9-2. Let's hear a little bit about Luo Chao, who's involved in our next featherweight contest.
Hello, my name is Luo Chao. I'm 18 years old. 这三年就是说给我的改变挺大的，让我从内而外就是说变得更自信了，同时也让外面的人对我刮目相看。看他们那些比较有名的那些运动员，感觉在擂台上那种感觉就是特别吸引我，他们拿到那些荣誉，包括底下的那些观众给他们的那些掌声，那些赞赏啊什么的，就是说很让我去仰慕。 因为我也很想有一天以后能够跟他们一样嘛。现在的战绩话是24战吧，其中有21场胜利，然后8次 KO， 我相信我是这个年龄段是绝对的一匹黑马。我的优势在于我的拳法比较突出，然后我的身高在这个级别算是比较优势的，然后我的技术算是比较全面的。近期的梦想呢是希望今年吧。 能够选上打上这个万冠军赛的主赛，能够跟张成龙、龙哥一起并肩作战。格斗对我来说可能算是我一生的事业，也是我通过这项格斗，我可以改变我的人生。
Luo Chao sharing with us that his dream is to compete in one championship. And that is the dream of his opponent for sure, and everyone else competing here today. This will be a featherweight kickboxing contest. We can learn a little bit more about Luo Chao by taking a look at the highlights of this 18-year-old so far.
Go to the glove. Go to the corner.
Wow, as I'm sure you enjoyed there looking at those two highlight reels, these are two very exciting young men. Zhang is 22 years old, Luo Chao is 18. These are the rules that they'll be competing under, three 3-minute rounds. The 10-point must system is in place. And remember, three knockdowns in a round represent a TKO. Zhang has a 23-6 record, Luo is 23-3. Exciting athletes, as you just saw. This is high-level stuff, Gianni. I'm looking forward to this.
Looking forward to this one. Both men with really, really good boxing. Zhang seems to have a little bit more power.
On the right of your screen there with the blue tape around his gloves, that is Zhang. And in those orange and black shorts, red tape around his wrists, Luo Chao. So here we go. Watch out for some explosive punching. Featherweight division, super serious kickboxing, looking to join the big time. We've already seen athletes elevate themselves from one hero series, one warrior series, to the big time, even become world champions on the big one championship stage, joining 140 world champions on the roster and exhibiting themselves to fans around over 140 countries.
Some very, very talented Chinese athletes in one championship. The champ, Xiong Jingnan. Former title challenger, Han Zihao.
They're all looking for Stamp Fairtex's kind of a journey, aren't they? Elevated from this kind of a stage to world championship on the big stage. Multiple world champion.
That one was a little bit low. You could hear the cup there. That was. That must have been painful.
Yeah, that's not the most pleasant sound to hear, is it? Especially when you know what it means. Little break in the action. Have you been hit by one of those central blows, Gianni?
I have, and it is not fun. It just throws you off. Got to take a couple seconds to breathe. You really need all the time to recover because it really, really affects you.
A little bit of a graze on the nose there, as you can see. Doesn't look too damaging at the moment. Zhang there will not be too bothered by it. May not even know about it at this stage.
See a little bit of redness on the nose of Zhang already.
Doesn't stop him smiling though. Oh, super right hand from Luo Chao.
What a chin on Zhang. Zhang seems to be unfazed at all.
You're absolutely right. He seems to take these very well. A couple of heavy blows there he's received, and he comes back throwing bombs. That left hand of his is pretty potent itself.
Luo is looking for the straight right now.
Got fast hands, Luo. In fact,
ooh, there you go, lands another one of them right hands.
He's really all action, Luo, actually. All movement, constantly. Zhang slightly more centered, slightly flatter on his feet, more planted, and that's where he gets his power from. A nice, cheeky little left hand there from Jiang Mengfei.
These great countering by Luo. Luo is putting the pressure on Zhang now.
Break! No!
Very forthright, that referee. And they'll listen to him. When you yell that like that, you tend to. Blow on the back of the head is what's being called. And that means that Jiang will have a little bit of time to recover. So they've both been sent to the naughty corner.
I think there was a short right in the clinch there that hit the back of the head of Jiang, but unintentional.
Yeah, neither of these two illegal blows that have been landed, we're certainly not saying were intentional, but both athletes need time to recover from those blows.
Ready?
Have a look at it.
Such a good combination there by Luo.
So they're back in the action, and they're both really moving at speed here.
Yeah, Luo stalking forward, putting the pressure on Zhang.
He's a constantly moving target.
That has when Luo found success, when he pressures forward, moves in with some feints, he has been able to find a home for the right straight right of his.
Super opening round, all action. Luo Chao, a perpetually moving target, but those planted feet that Jiang has exhibited means that he can throw with big power, and that's probably the interesting feature when these two come together, because it's a nice matchup, isn't it? Two slightly different styles. That was the blow of the
beautiful
round,
beautiful right hand there. Uses the left hand to distract Jiang and then lands the straight right over. He landed a couple of the straight rights the whole round, but beautiful double jab. The jab is what Jiang needs to do to prevent Luo from coming forward, but this is a long combination there by Jiang. By Luo, excuse me.
Yeah, he's got all action, hasn't he, when he's coming forward. Once he gets the bit between his teeth, the momentum doesn't stop and he just throws lefts and rights.
Jiang had some success of his own in the round by moving forward, backing Luo up, but then again, Luo is always looking to counter as well. This is a great matchup. Very skilled athletes, both these men.
On the left of your screen, I should say, Luo Chao, only three losses, 23-3 his record. He's got a lot to protect. And he's only 18 years old.
Unbelievable.
And slapping kicks to the leg of his opponent. Nice right hand.
That's what he was
and
doing.
And again.
Those little kicks were not heavy strikes. All they were doing were to set up the right hand of Luo.
His hands are so quick that he can lead with that big right hand. Often, athletes like to set themselves up with a jab and then land the big blow. But he's got such fast hands, he can just send that one in without any warning at all.
Very, very smart striking by Luo. Look at him. He knows he has the right hand down. Now all these little shots are to set up the right hand there.
Oh, and that
there
was a heavy right
is.
Hand. It was the 1-2, Gianni, wasn't it? He's got a very quick left jab as well, and he set himself up for a nice 1-1-2 there. Now, we're getting a complaint from Zhang about a blow on the back of the head. But I don't think that's going to be accepted by the referee. Let's have a listen. Well, obviously the doctor's in there. I don't think the referee saw anything on the back of the head. That's why he gave him a count. If he had seen it, he wouldn't have counted it. Let's take a look at your thoughts, Gianni.
Let's see here. Right hand lands, moves forward with the left hook. I think that was a legal shot, but...
Legal?
I thought it was legal, but let's see. Let's see.
I didn't see anything illegal there.
But before that, Luo was starting to find a home for the right hand of his. Sets it up with some jabs. Taking away, distracting Zhang, and then moved forward with the right hand. That's what high-level strikers do. They distract you, they set you up for the power shots.
We may see the end of the contest here. You and I didn't see anything untoward. The referee obviously didn't either. That's why he gave a count. And it's over. I think what we're seeing is... I think he just can't continue. I think that's the issue. Sometimes, I suppose, I mean, you could tell me, when blows are raining down on you, you can't be totally aware of where they're landing. So it's not surprising that maybe you appeal for an illegal blow, but they were solid, solid punches.
Solid punches by Luo. He might have been a little bit disorientated, yeah. And I can see how he thought it was a strike to the back of the head, but good, great job by Luo.
Yeah, super exhibition.
To set up the right hands that resulted in the finish of this bout. Again, look at the replay. Right cross, left hook. Follows up with another right straight. That right hand was the story of this bout. Luo was just able to find a home for his right hand all night.
Oh, super stuff. 24-3, and Gianni's 18 years old.
Bright, bright future ahead for this guy.
Well, that future will end up at one championship if he can continue to impress. And he might find himself on the kind of stage that we'll see in Manila on August the 2nd. We can look forward to that. There are some huge contests coming up there.
Manila, here we go!
Matt knew it, shocks the world! Smack, bang, and again! That's the night I read!
The Filipino Fury of Edward Filaye!
The ticking time bomb's exploded! Oh, boom shakalaka! This is crazy! It's over! It's over!
Couple of world title contests happening in Manila. In the here and now, it's the bantamweight division. Liu Mengyu takes on Wang Jingjia. This is mixed martial arts. And let's take a look at some of the highlights that Liu has provided for us in recent bouts. Two very talented athletes here. Here we are then, bantamweight division. Liu against Wang. Jeff in Australia, thanks very much for your comments. We're enjoying those. Let's give you a reminder of the global rule set. 3 5-minute rounds here. Bouts judged in their entirety for mixed martial arts. No kicks to the head of a grounded opponent. Hello to Jojo in Abu Dhabi, Pete in Pennsylvania, Pauline in the Philippines. Get yourself along to that Manila event if you can, Pauline. We've got viewers in Angola as well. So great, all around the world. We're reaching combat sports fans. And you're seeing what could be the future of the sport. Auditioning themselves, if you like, for the big stage, the one championship stage. Liu with the red tape around his gloves, Wang with the blue. 13-9 record Wang has.
Wang came out feinting really hard. Gets a takedown on Liu.
Wang is the oldest athlete on show today at 27 years old. Which goes some way to explaining that.
Beautiful control by Wang.
22 contest record. Liu has a 3-2 record. 24 years old, and he's the one with his back to the deck at the moment.
Yeah, Wang's doing a great job of controlling Liu. Has the head trapped and the lower body controlled as well. Wang, excuse me, Liu, not anywhere to go right now. Wang is going to slowly progress, try to make Liu turn in and take his back.
Liu's using that right hand to try and push those legs away and prevent that knee to the midriff that you've just seen, and again, coming back from a long way. He's got that arm in between knee and body, though, to just lessen the blow, dampen the blow. That one got all the way through, though.
What Liu is looking to do is hip in and try to get an underhook on the left side. Look at him trying to sneak that left hand up, but Wang is doing a very, very good job controlling the head and the hips of Liu.
Almost in a sort of north-south position there for a while, but
Wang attempted a north-south choke there, but no, goes back to controlling the body of Liu.
That knee, if it lands, is coming back from an awfully long way back, isn't it?
Yep. Just great control by Wang. Top control, beautiful positioning. Constantly adjusting, not giving Liu any space to get out. But there you go, Wang. Liu, with a little bit of patience, is trying to hook the right leg of Wang to hook up a half guard here, but no, you see how Wang is constantly adjusting?
So I was just about to ask you, what's he trying to do? It looks like he's trying to move to north-south.
Yeah, there he is. That is what he wants to do. Wang is...
Spins all the way around, actually.
Oh, but Liu locks up. Oh, Liu might have a triangle. No.
They gave up on that fairly quickly. Got to watch his elbows, though, hasn't he, Wang? Just to make sure he gets a nice bit of distance between him now. You got to watch that heel coming in.
Yes, he does, but Wang looks to be very, very experienced. Taking his time. He knows that he's been controlling the whole round. Got another two rounds to go. Just taking his time here. But Liu needs to be a little bit more urgent.
Wang just managed to step aside of that that up kick, that heel coming in, which can be very damaging indeed.
Liu might roll for a knee bar here. Oh, doesn't have it.
2 minutes left of the opening round.
Wang ends up on side control.
Put his knee on that arm.
Yep, he wants to pin and lock down the arm. There you go. Beautiful grappling display by Wang. Very, very intelligent grappling.
Takes a knee to the head.
He has the left arm of Liu trapped. Hips really, really tight to Liu's body.
Manages to get his hand on the hip, though, just to push his opponent away.
Liu is trying to create frames, but this is what Wang wants. Wang wants him to turn in so that he can make a mistake and give him his back.
Could he get that arm under the chin? No, is the answer.
Liu's going to end up on top here. Great work, staying patient by Liu. Let's see what Liu can do from the top position. Wang, majority of the round was Wang on top. Let's see what Liu does.
At the moment, being pulled in nice and close. That seemed like a bit of a headbutt. And the referee will warn him for that. It seemed quite clear.
Headbutts are illegal.
Totally illegal, yeah. Sometimes you can use that head to push your opponent's head one way or another. As we say, control the head, you control the body.
Yep. Wang has an overhook on the left arm of Liu. He's going to look to attack the left arm, or right arm rather, of Liu, but now Liu pops it up. Has the overhook again. You see the overhook that he has controlling, it controls the arms of Liu, doesn't allow him to strike, and controls the posture.
Strong
of
pair
him
of
as well.
Legs around his waist. They'll be constricting his airways, making it tougher. We've already had 4.5 minutes of this opening round, and these two will be gassed already, I'm sure.
Yeah, Wang seems to be content with just holding right now.
Yeah, pulling each other in close will go a long way to nullifying, but it looks like...
Yeah, looks to attack a straight arm lock, but no, doesn't have it.
Looks like he was trying hard for something with the arm, the left arm. But we're going to get to the end of this opening round, and that was very intriguing indeed. Some high-level stuff on the canvas.
Back and forth round, but Wang spent the majority of the round on top. Great control from side position, constantly adjusting, not allowing Liu to get out, but Liu was able to reverse it towards the end of the round and landed some good strikes of his own.
Well, it was during his sophomore year at college in Beijing that he tried Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for the first time, Wang, and developed a love that I'm sure has continued.
Yeah, there's a highlight here. Liu, controlling inside control, landed some good knees to the body and the head. And then Wang able to reverse the position, ends up on top to end the round.
What a nice combination to have. We talk about combinations in mixed martial arts, what your various bases are. Wang has a deep foundation in both boxing and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Perhaps Muay Thai and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu might be the ideal situation, because then you involve the strikes with the legs.
That's why it's exciting.
Exactly.
So many different possible styles that you can pick up.
Second round then. Every round starts on its feet. How long will it take for this one to go back down to the mat? Because that's where it got very interesting, this contest. Jab to the head, jab to the body from Wang.
Liu was supposed to have the wrestling advantage, but Wang was the one to take Liu down in the beginning of the first. Wang has been fighting really, really hard, but oh, single leg picks him up.
Oh, that's heavy.
Beautiful double leg or slam, single leg slam rider by Liu.
Figure four leg lock, just taking that right arm out of action.
Yeah, oh, Wang's
and
looking
the
for
head.
A reverse,
now he's looking
a triangle
for a,
here.
Yeah, that's right. He's look, it's like head and arm in, isn't it?
But he's not going to get it.
It looks high, though. It looks high on the head.
Look at the knee of Liu on the belly, pressuring, creating space, and now he's going to pass to side control.
Also working that left arm of Wang.
Yeah. Wang is looking for a potential Kimura, but yeah. No, look at how
slipped out.
Liu uses the knee to drive and passes. Great job by Liu. Early in the second round, their bodies are not that sweaty yet, so you can still get purchase on these limbs. Yep. Wang had, Liu rather, had his hands clasped possession for a second there. Just keeping the back of Wang flat on the mat.
Really picking on that left arm of Wang.
Wang's doing a great job with his butterfly hook. See how his legs are in the middle of Liu? He's using that to elevate Liu.
Yes.
To create some off-balancing so he can look for submissions or look to sweep.
Oh, big, big right hand.
Good right hand there, believe.
They're face to face there, but it's difficult to bring it out round and down again. It's a big movement. But he's done it very well there. That's
been
good
able
work
to sneak in a couple right hands.
Yeah, that's good work from him.
Beautiful passing. You see how Liu pushes the knee of Wang across the body and passes the side control.
Liu with that 3-2 record, 24 years old, plenty of good years ahead of him. One championship the stage is aiming for, with 140 world champions
Liu
in various combat sports.
Has his arms locked up. Oh, guillotine, locks up a guillotine, that's tight. He might have it. Oh no, but he's okay, he's cross-body there. Relieving the pressure with his shoulder, pinning, yep. Gets out of it, but no.
If he can get
Liu stays
out
on the guillotine. But he's okay here. You see how Wang passes across the body of Liu. That relieves a lot of the pressure, relieves the choke. But now, Liu himself is in dangerous position. He might have a von Flu there, but no, he gives it up. Back and forth grappling exchanges here by both men.
Yeah, it really is back and forth, isn't it? It was a very enthralling first round. And there's Xin on arm. So that's the left arm.
Wow.
Recovered very nicely.
Has Liu in crucifix position. Not a good spot for Liu to be.
Poked some little punches there with that sort of front part of the fist.
Bad
throws
in
the odd elbow
Liu
as well.
It's
not a good spot, is it, for Liu? Somewhat trapped. Has to do a sort of bucking bronco impression to try and change the position.
That's what Liu needs to do. He needs to bump left, he needs to bump right, try to get one of his arms free.
He's opened up a cut with that elbow on Liu's right eye, and it's not looking good for him.
This is a bad, bad spot for Liu.
It was the elbow that did it, and he's continuing to work in that same area. So it's good work from Wang here. Minute and a half, just less than that, in this second round.
Liu needs to keep bumping left and right, keep rocking, create a little space to get one of those arms free, because this is a fast bump for Wang. The referee is going to, oh, there you go. Keep coming up, beautiful work by the
strength.
But you must think that those strikes, elbows, the cut that opened up is scored heavily for Wang. Liu needs to make it up. Liu needs to score some significant strikes.
And now it's getting a little bit slippery.
Beautiful sweep by Wang. Wang used the forearm across the face of Wang used the forearm across the face of Liu to sweep him. He had potential heel hook here. Oh, he might have it.
Is he going to
might have it?
It doesn't look comfortable at all, does it?
Seems okay here. He needs to roll through. That's a kick. Kick on the butt of Liu and roll through. He's okay here. Then they're gonna end up
trying to manipulate that foot so that the ankle and the knee causes problems.
Another back and forth matchup here.
This is some round. It's been some contest. Final 15 seconds.
Hard round to score.
And the hardest working people will be those who have to work on that cut in the next minute or so. Fantastic entertainment.
Liu ends up on top.
Constant movement, constant changes in position. The advantage going from one man to the other. That was some round, Gianni.
Close, what a round that was. Wang was on the bottom for the majority of the round, but then was able to switch, reversed the position, end up on top, got the crucifix position, landed some elbows. This was the slam. Picks up the single leg, slams Wang on his head.
Textbook, wasn't it? Tremendous strength. Later on, we had this issue of elbows and forearms coming down, which did the damage. And
this was
the
position
scores.
That was in. Liu was able to secure the crucifix position and land those short little elbows. That opened up the cut on Wang, but Wang reverses the position, ends up on top. Close round to score.
So you're describing them as short little elbows, and that's right on the button. Not tremendous power, but the accuracy And the timing and the sharpness of the elbow is what did the damage.
Slicing elbows, Steve.
Slicing elbows, I like that. And damage, of course, is an element of ONE Championship scoring, and that'll be something that opens the eyes of the judges. You can see the mark, it's there for all to see. And this is an important round now.
This is anyone's to take. I feel like whoever wins this round is going to win this bout.
Remember, the judges will look at the contest in its entirety. Oh, and these are great right hands.
Looping hooks by Liu.
He's going right hand hungry.
But Wang comes back with a couple hooks of his own. No.
That was poorly done, wasn't
pulls
it?
Pulls himself into the mount, but no, he has half guard here.
Maybe he's just okay, tied himself out, throwing those right hands in.
Not a position Liu wants to be in the third round of a very, very closely contested bout.
Well, that was an error. Could it be an error that determines the way this contest is going to go?
A lot of time for Liu to work still. This is not the end yet.
That cut above the eye is leaking again. It takes a lot of strength to be in that position when you're standing up like that and you're carrying the entire weight of your opponent. A lot of tension on the back. The referee will reposition them, I think. I'm sure they'll get back into the same position, but they won't be tangled up with the ropes there.
The reset in the middle of the ring.
Well, it doesn't seem to be precisely the same position they were in, but no complaints from either man.
Wang in the full guard of Liu, landing some shots to the body.
A little bit of tape from the glove of Liu that may cause the referee to just delay proceedings for a while he gets rid of that.
This is valuable time on top for Wang.
That's the position they were in.
Liu does not want to be here. Liu needs to look to sweep or submit Wang, because this is a very, very close bout, and if Wang ends the round on top, this decision might go to him, Steve.
Liu will be looking to tie up Wang's hands, make sure he doesn't throw down anymore.
Liu locks up a triangle. No, it doesn't happen. Wang slips up, so slippery. This is the third round. Both men's so slippery.
Yeah, that's the problem now, isn't it? Getting that purchase is going to be difficult from here on
Wang
in.
Wang's going to pass the side control here. Beautiful passing. Pushes across the knee, ends up in side control. But is he able to keep control? Liu has to. You see how he's controlling the wrist and pushing on the elbow? He's going to look to move his head to the middle, look to grab a single leg and come back on top, but no.
Meanwhile, that right hand, well, looks for the throat, but it's nullified, isn't it, by two gloves.
Great work for Wang to keep top position.
This is really intriguing stuff. We're approaching the final 2 minutes of the contest now. Judges, remember, let me emphasize, scoring this bout in its entirety, so we're not going round by round here in mixed martial arts. They'll look at the entire 15 minutes.
Wang looking to take it back again, but Liu has the wrists of Wang control, so he's okay here. He's gonna, yeah, there you go.
Kick that's to the head of a grounded opponent is not allowed. Whether he connected with the head or not, I'm not sure. There was arm and shoulder in there deflecting the way, but it didn't look good, did it? It didn't look like what we want to see.
That seemed to be a clear illegal strike by Wang.
Liu sent to a neutral corner. Wang will be reviewed. Let's take another look and see the extent to which there was contact.
Yeah, I can't really see it from this angle.
Still yet to be convinced, but it didn't look good. Let's put it that way.
That was in the heat of the moment, you know. Liu was on the bottom the whole round.
Yeah, it
finally is got free. May have got his emotions. Got his emotions get the better of him.
It'd be a terrible shame if we can't see an actual conclusion to this contest, because it has been a thriller from start to finish. Now, while attention is being given to Wang, the doctor comes in and just makes sure that that mark above Liu's eye is seen to as well.
Wang taking his time, as he should.
Interesting that he's allowed treatment on the eye while there's a timeout for a foul blow. Just testing his vision there. You think he's okay?
He puts his mouth. He put his mouth back in. Mouth guard back in.
So the indications are that we will resume. Just taking a look at some of the action here from earlier on.
This is a different look, different angle. I think he just clipped him a little bit.
I think he might have just clipped him. That's the closest I've seen to contact. See if this gives us, does this give us another angle? Let's take another look. Again, it's inconclusive, isn't it? That third replay, that if this was the fourth, the third one that we saw did perhaps indicate that there was a little clip. I wouldn't say it was heavy, but it's an illegal blow, very clear. Very clear indeed. Thankfully, these two can continue because it's been an absolutely engaging contest.
Another nice show of sportsmanship by both men.
Yep. That's what one championship is all about.
Oh, locks in the double leg, beautiful outside trip. Wang, so smart, knew that this was the end of the round.
Yeah, it was the sheer weight of his assertion that drove him forward, wasn't it?
Had a little break to get his stamina back, get his gas back, and now he's trying to put the pressure on Liu again. That was a veteran move by Wang.
Looking to land the blows from high ups. Got to be careful of that heel to the face, which landed. Decent work this from Liu.
Oh, wow. No, he's okay here. Passes the side control. This is not what Liu wants. Liu needs to move.
Both of these men clearly know what's at stake, though, don't they?
Liu's coming up with a single leg.
Hand round the throat. Not quite in position, but now he might be in a better position.
That was a beautiful, you see how he got the seatbelt, switched his hip, used that momentum to drag Liu to the ground.
It's all about hands around the throat now, defensive and offensive.
Wang, we call this a modified mount position, but now ends up with both hooks.
No, they're both under that throat now. Can he just keep his chin down? You can still submit with a sort of crank by cranking that chin inwards.
Wang's in dominant position here. He should keep position. Right out the round, end up on top.
Yeah, can't
let's
be
see if
left.
He's able to. There you go. Applies the pressure on the hips. Look at him.
Pushing the hips down, yep. Lifting the shoulders up.
Flattening the hips of Liu.
Pulls out. Gets back in again.
Oh, but he's a little bit high. Oh, he's going to give up the position. And now Liu ends up on top with a little bit of time left to work. But is it too little too late? 10 seconds left.
Who can leave the lasting impression in the judges' eyes? Because they will inevitably be called upon now. It's been an enthralling, intriguing battle, much of it on the canvas. Marvelous work, tremendously energetic, great technique from both men, and of course, wonderful sportsmanship at all times.
Great contest by both men. Liu seems to think he has done enough to take it, but I would give that one to Wang.
Well, let's see. I dare not usher an, offer
right.
an opinion on
You're
that
right.
one.
We made a mistake just now. But this is the beginning of the round.
Oh, super work,
Liu
wasn't it?
Coming forward with some hard hooks, but you see there, Wang comes back with hooks of his own.
Both of them going at it.
This was the illegal strike that was landed by Liu. Just a little, clipped him a little bit on the head.
You know, we talk
kicks
about
to the ground opponent are illegal here in one championship. Let's see who this decision goes to.
Tension mounts. We hear it's a split decision. Who's got it?
Winner.
Blue corner. There it is. Wang takes it. Improves his record to 14-9.
Well-deserved win by Wang.
Fabulous effort. Great entertainment. Sometimes not easy to appreciate the level of entertainment when they spend so much time on the ground, but that was easy enough.
然后拳法比较好一点，对手的权很好，然后但是我要利用我的身高臂展的优势，去和他打一个游击的打法。我的技术特点就是打近身战，这段时间就是一直在努力的加强自己的步伐和腿法，然后他的腿法还有膝法比较差，所以我要利用他的这些短板去攻击他。张婉欣确实是一个非常优秀的选手。 这段时间研究你，我感觉赢你不成问题。我觉得我这次100%能胜，这次我要 KO 你。我理想的获胜方式是以 KO 获胜。我会尽我最大的努力进入主赛。晚冠军赛的正赛的名额我不会让给你的，一定会属于我。咱们擂台上见。
Our final bout of the evening is in the featherweight division. This is Super Series Kickboxing. Zhang Wan Xin against Rui Lei. We've seen some really engaging contests so far this evening, and this could be the best of them. Three 3-minute rounds coming your way. The judges for this one will use the 10-point must system. Recall that 3 knockdowns in a single round represents an automatic technical knockout. With the blue tape around his gloves, Zhang is 31-5. He's 21 years old. Young man, his opponent, exactly the same age. Here he is, and he has a 26-3 record. He's got good stamina, Gianni. Powerful punches, likes to brawl a bit. So we may see some exciting all-action stuff. Bit of a buzzsaw by all accounts.
Must have saved this one for the last for a reason.
Seems sensible, doesn't it? Little tete-a-tete with the referee. Zhang is a big fan of Bruce Lee. Read the books, watched the films. Now he's walking the walk. All in black, Zhang, looking menacing. Left lead, smiled in reply by Lu. Fast start again. That overhand right from Zhang. Oh, big knee to the chin. And the flying knee again. Doesn't look, Gianni, as if Zhang wants this one to last too long.
But Lu comes forward with strikes of his own.
Is Zhang a little bit too excitable? He's left himself up to a few blows there with a sort of open stance, perhaps overcommitting himself.
Yeah, Zhang is attacking the body. A couple right straights to the body, knees, kicks as well. Look at that straight line attacks.
So accurate as well, Gianni, really. That was right on the chin.
Beautiful sense of range by Zhang, slipping away from the straight of Lu as well.
But he is leaving himself a little bit exposed when he commits like that, isn't he? And Lu looks to be sharp enough to send in the odd straight punch, straight blow that could make him pay.
Zhang has this range advantage, so he's able to get away with that. Look at that. As he moves away, even though his chin's high, he's still in position to counter-strike.
Definitely a pattern developing here. Lu seems to be an effective counter-attacker. Zhang seems to be setting the pace. The perfect recipe for an entertaining 9 minutes if we get that far. Decent right hand from Zhang.
Yeah, Zhang's straight line strikes have been landing. Straight, two straights, couple knees.
Big left hand, and he'll look for it again. It's been the potent weapon. It lands heavily again from Zhang there in that southpaw position. Sending that left hand is punishing.
Zhang is on a mission here. He wants to take out Lu and make a statement.
Last bout of the evening. These two know they can leave a lasting impression. Maybe get that invitation to the big show. One championship beckons.
Yeah, you see how Zhang is landing that straight right? And coming down the middle with knees as well.
This left hand, how much more can Lu take of this, Gianni? Because it's landing flush consistently.
You see Zhang starting to loop the left hand over. Being very smart, throwing some straight line strikes and coming over the guard with some looping shots as well.
One of the more beautiful punches to see is a left hook to the body, and Lu just exhibited a super effort there. A bit of a pedestrian swinging, spinning back kick that didn't look particularly good. That flying knee is becoming a bit of a habit.
Yep. You see Zhang is lining himself up, moving his hips across the left side to line up the power side of him, of Zhang.
Amazingly, we're in the final 10 seconds of this round. No wonder it's gone so quickly. It's been all action from start to finish. Loving this. Let's hope they get out of this one and they'll give us a second round. What fantastic entertainment that was.
Great job by Zhang, landing his power shots. The right hand, the right straight, and the right knees, those have been his weapons this round. He's also been attacking with kicks to the body and then occasionally looping over with the right hook. So he's coming in from all angles, Zhang.
Great chance to see some of the blows that landed here. A couple of misses.
Beautiful
there.
Beautiful range,
left hand, isn't it?
Beautiful range. Slips up, slips away, and then lands a straight right of his own. Look at that range. Beautiful range management. But look at how smart and patient he is. Ooh, he's not running in. He's coming in, hands up, still very defensively responsible.
No question, he is setting the pace. Zhang, he's got a powerful left hand. He's got a spectacular flying right knee. And Lu needs to settle himself. It's an important 1 minute for the man on the other side of the ring here to listen to his corner men and decide how to approach this.
Lu needs to start moving a little bit more, try to move away from the power side of Zhang. He also needs to try to utilize a little bit more lateral movement. Maybe try to clinch up.
The thing about a big left hand and then a flying right knee is which way do you go to avoid the power?
That's the problem. Zhang is doing a great job of mixing it up, not being too predictable. So it's very, very hard for Lu to time.
Yeah,
to figure him out.
He seems to have it all set up. The only little piece of exposure is that he doesn't protect himself so well, and a handy counter-attacker could have some success. But now all the success is with Zhang, landing cleanly. And I have to credit Lu again for having a decent enough chin to absorb these attacks and keep coming for more.
Lu has not been fazed at all by the strikes. Maybe he has a really good poker face, but none of those big strikes have seemed to faze him yet.
Ultimately, it's going to take more than a poker face, but you're absolutely right. He's done a good job of saying, you haven't hurt me yet.
You see how Zhang is just always inching his left foot to the middle or to the outside, always having that out position.
Lu has got to start showing that he can land with some power as well. Early on, he did.
Yep. Lu is just walking himself into the power side of Zhang.
It's not enough just to stand there and take the punches. Nice right hand from
him. Right hand.
He's easing himself into this contest, but he ate two big ones in return.
Wow.
It could all be a little bit too much for Lu. Zhang will wear his man down halfway through the second round.
How tough is Lu?
Yeah, absolutely. But he's got to show us a bit more, hasn't he?
Has to land some significant strikes of his own. Oh, another hard knee to the body. The power side strikes of Zhang has been landing all night.
And he's using his height so effectively as well.
Zhang has been starting to go high with the head kick as well on the left side. Let's see if he tries to go to that.
You look and think about what Lu can perhaps do, maybe attack the body. There he goes with that decent left hand. He showed us that once or twice. It looks good. He digs it in.
Lu needs to throw some feints, try to draw the strikes of Zhang out and look to counter, because
referee nearly got taken out there.
There you go. That's what he needs to do.
Every time he shows us something, though, Gianni, he eats a couple, doesn't he?
Zhang comes right back. But that's what Lu needs to do. He needs to make this a dog battle. Zhang, at the range, Zhang is winning that battle.
Lu is digging in, though. He is certainly giving it his
biggest effort. No questioning the toughness of Lu.
It's just that, well, that might give him a little bit of confidence to see his opponent on his backside, working the body as we suggested he might. And a good little flurry there towards the end of this second round. Clips him with the right hand and then goes downstairs with the left. It's good work.
Good way to end the round for Lu.
Probably not enough, you know, to take that round. But it's good to open the judges' eyes, isn't it? And it'll be good for confidence going into the final stanza.
Yep, that's what he needs to do. Lu needs to find some success with some boxing inside the clinch. He cannot stay on the outside, because that is where Zhang has been picking him apart this whole contest. Looping right hook. But this is the straights that have been landing for Lu. But look at that. Zhang just counters right back with two shots of his own and the third knee down the middle.
It's interesting to look at Lu and figure out what he can do to turn this bout around. But all the while we're doing that, we're ignoring the energy and the effectiveness of Zhang, who has put on quite an exhibition here.
Lu needs to try and go forward. He needs to utilize lateral movement, try to feint, draw the strike of Zhang out so he can counter, and then keep throwing strikes after he's inside the range, because on the outside, he is losing this battle. You can see that at the end of the second round, Lu was starting to find some success by combinations with the hands. So he needs to get into the range, fire up, and keep firing the combinations.
That seems spot on to me. Zhang is winning this at distance. Liu is coming in, being effective to the body, but he's being punished at the same time.
See, now he's finding a little bit of success. This is what he needs to do, but he's backing up, which is not what he wants to do. Because every time he backs up, they reset and they give Zhang the range that he is dominant in.
It just seems that Zhang has got a little bit too much at every level. But Liu's
finding some great success this round.
Yeah, coming back. But he needs to come back more than marginally. Needs to stamp some authority on this bout. Left hand was right on the button from Zhang.
Zhang doing a great job of measuring the range with his front hand.
Apart from the first minute or so, those flying knees and the standing knees from Zhang, they look good. They're not necessarily landing cleanly. There's a lot of arm in between knee and face and knee and body. Credit to Liu for doing that, for protecting himself.
Zhang circles Liu to the corner of the ropes. Not where Liu wants to be. Both men seem to slow down a bit, but no. It's been a furious pace this third round.
I was just going to ask that question. Is there a sign that they're slowing down? Because as you say, dynamic pace in the first 6 minutes. I don't think these two are slowing. They're back at it, straight in, not looking for a breather anywhere.
Beautiful left hook over the top by Liu.
High on the head, it landed, which can sometimes cause problems with the equilibrium. Nice straight right hand, right on the jaw from Zhang. His accuracy of punching has been first class.
First class. Zhang has just been so good with his range tonight.
Yeah, you're right, range. He's hardly missed a punch, has he?
Accuracy and range, just been there for him all night. Every strike that he's thrown, he seems to have been landing.
Well, inside the final minute, these two 21-year-olds showing the energy of their youth for all to see. How will the judges see it with 40 seconds left?
Liu just starting to move back, but he's finding a little bit of success because Zhang is getting a little bit fatigued as well. But this is what he needs to do. See how when he goes forward, he finds success. When he starts throwing combinations, he's successful. But every time he moves back, he goes back into the range of Zhang. Look at that. Zhang posting with his front hand. That's when he knows he has the range. He can land that powerful right, and straight left, and the knee.
Seamless movement between knee and hand from Zhang. It's really impressive stuff from him. Liu is a wonderful athlete. I want to see more of him. I certainly do. But on the night,
He just hasn't quite
had enough, has he?
No, I don't think so. Just a wonderful and impressive display of striking by Zhang.
And what a way to end this one hero series with an all-out battle between these two. Wonderful Zhang, entertainment.
Zhang has been able to land shot after shot all night, because he was able to find his range early and often. The powerful straight right, looping left has been there from all night. The jumping knee to the middle, Zhang just showcasing all angles, strikes from all angles.
Even in slow motion, those blows just came relentlessly, didn't they? Wonderful, wonderful entertainment. I suspect we know which way the judges are going to give this, but...
But what a battle by Liu as well. Yeah. Never gave up. We're starting to come back in the third round, but gave too much space for Zhang to find the range, and then Zhang seemed to take over at the latter stages of the third round.
Fabulous kickboxer, Liu. Really want to see him again. I loved his left hook to the body and his counter-punching ability, but you can't necessarily win being reactive. The man who sets the pace is often the man in combat sports who will take the advantage. And I think what we'll see here, I'm hearing it, a unanimous decision. Which way will it go? The man with the blue tape around his gloves, I suspect, is the more hopeful of the two. And there it is. Declared the winner. His record improves to 32-5. Hope you've enjoyed the entertainment here from Beijing, China. Don't forget, one championship in Manila on August the 2nd. That is going to be an absolute barn burner with a couple of world titles. Gianni Suba, Steve Dawson saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.